Now, which popular game traditionally ends with all the players being thrown into a lake of fiery sulphur?
Well, I hope it's show jumping. Nice. I hate show jumping. Oh, God. I'd have one of those after every jump.
Before and after.
Yeah.
It's not show jumping, though. It would certainly liven it up.
It sounds biblical.
I don't think it's the humans, though, is it? It's pieces. Wouldn't it be pieces?
Well, I'll tell you that it's a game that went dramatically out of fashion in 1972. Early 72, it was more popular than Monopoly. But by the end of 72, it had almost completely gone out of fashion because of a film.
Mousetrap. Mousetrap.
No, there is no film of
because
Mousetrap.
Of a film. Is it Drafts? Remember that film, Drafts?
The film's true.
The truth about Drafts.
No.
Drafts makes you go bald. Don't play Drafts.
The film is not a game. There's a game in it.
There's a game in
this game is played in it, and it's scary.
Oh, is it a seance?
Yeah, is a seance using a Ouija board.
Okay.
Right. And what film has there a Ouija board?
The Exorcist
is the right answer. One of the truly great films of the 20th century.
Is a Ouija board really a game? I don't remember ever seeing Ouija board scenes in a film and at the end going, right, who won?
I'm here, not dead. Well, the odd thing about Ouija, it was a board, it still belongs to Parker Brothers.
Get out!
Ouija's a proprietary name, it's a trademark.
Is it Ouija?
Interesting point. That is some people's theory of the name of it is, yes, two words for yes, we, the French, and ya, the German, but no one's quite sure about where the name came from, except that it's a game that was invented. The board was invented and it was sold and people played it. I mean, it's weird to say that, but they enjoyed the fact that it nearly always works in as much as, you know, people spell out words and they don't quite know how they're doing it. It's clearly not dead people.
Yeah.
And in fact, it was not originally supposed to be dead people. It was supposed to be that you contacted yourselves, a part of yourselves that automatically wrote. It was not about seances.
Dead people just joined in. This is the one for us.
Even when recently asked, only a third of the people who still use Ouija boards say they do it to contact dead people. And in the First World War, it was used to contact your troops abroad, supposedly.
So hold on. Are some dead people trying to communicate with the living through Monopoly?
Yeah. There was a court case in the 90s, I'm sorry to say, in Britain, a murder case, quite an important one, and the jury had to be dismissed because in their hotel overnight, they used a Ouija board to try and contact the murdered person. And apparently the murdered person said, the guy in the dock is guilty, convict him. Really? And said, the judge heard about it and dismissed the jury, quite rightly, you may say. But the awful thing was, if they'd done it in the jury room, the judge couldn't have dismissed them. Because the judge has no right in law to know what goes on in a jury room. The deliberations must be private.
Unless he's dead.
Yeah, that's really complicated.
Was the guy guilty?
Unfortunately, he was retried and found guilty, which sort of is really irritating. So maybe the ghost of the murdered person did.
Where's the competitive element?
I suppose you just have a go.
Yeah.
Who are you trying to contact? Right, it's your turn.
Yeah, exactly.
Or you contact two dead people and then they box.
Tell you how it went. Ghost boxing.
Ghost boxing.
Like Sky Sports 2. Live ghost boxing from Auntie Vera's parlour. That's it, people in sheets.
Yeah.
The headless man, he's already down. It's just going like that. It's kind of punchy.
Do you know there's an Elvis?
Yeah.
There we go. Go on. Hit me.
There's an Elvis seance website.
Of course there is. I bet there's more than one of those.
Yeah. Where you contact Elvis.
Online?
But it cautions... if you wish to repeat this experiment, please be considerate. Many people may wish to contact Elvis, and we're sure he's quite busy. Please treat this information...
For eternity.
Yes. Please treat this information the same as you would if he were alive and you had his email address. With respect. It's a terrifying thought, isn't it? A sort of posthumous Twitter and things like that. That would be hell, I have to say.
Have you just thought of that?
Yeah.
You're in it up to your neck.
Oh, God. Horrifying. But the reference in the Bible to the fiery lake or whatever is from Revelations, where it does say those who practice the magic arts will be cast into burning sulphur.
So... How about balloon animals?
Ooh, the punishment for people who do balloon animals is not specified in Revelation.
A giraffe.
I think it's loneliness, the punishment for them. Yeah. Long nights, sitting alone.
So, yeah, in my youth, games which conjured up the spirits of the dead were a popular gift for children. It's a weird thought. If they didn't like it, they could go to hell.